Perfect. Thank you. Welcome, everybody. My name is Eva Bersat, and today we are talking about Viva Connections. It's a brand new session because I was working on this session since the beginning of Viva Connection, and this time it's the first time I'm presenting this session with all the stuff and all the demos. So I'm really excited to show you a lot of demos. So I'm going through the slides as quick as possible, and after we are straight go to the demos. This is the most important thing for me today. So thank you for the organizer and sponsors, because we need the support of a sponsor for organize this this conference. So thank you. And you have a quiz, and I heard you can win some amazing prizes. So don't forget to answer the question, and you will be maybe picked for the prizes. So don't forget. Just a lot of words about me. I'm Eva Bersat. I'm a business application consultant at Sword Group in Switzerland. So my main areas are Microsoft 365, Azure, Dynamics 365, Power Platform, and a little bit of ServiceNow. I'm a Microsoft Certified Trainer focused on development technologies like SharePoint Framework, Team SDK, TypeScript, React, .NET Core, and a lot of other things related to development technology and modern development technologies with Microsoft 365 and Azure. So basically for today, we have three objectives. So the first is to understand what are the Viva Connection native features, to show you what are the basic features, what you get with Viva Connections. The second is to understand the available extension points, which are available in GA. And at the end, we are going through the public preview, which is running out, and I will show you all the features related to public preview, like SharePoint Framework, like dashboard, feed, and other stuff like this. So this is a really demo-focused session, but I need to show you some basic stuff in the slides. So the agenda, just a quick recap of Microsoft Viva about modules and availability. Next, we are going to just a quick reminder about what is Viva Connection, how to deploy Viva Connection, and what's new with Viva Connection. And just after, the extensibility option with SharePoint Framework, Power Apps, Power BI a little bit, and public preview features. At the end, if you have any question or technical question, I will answer with pleasure. So basically, Microsoft Viva is an employee experience with four modules. The first is Viva Insights, which is a brand new app in Microsoft Teams with all the services like My Analytics, Workplace Analytics, and Glint. The second is Viva Topics. It's knowledge management and expertise. The third is Viva Learning. It's just a learning management system, and you can discover learning content like informal or formal content in the daily work context inside Microsoft Teams. And the last is Viva Connections, which is a brand new app in Microsoft Teams desktop and mobile app, which include all the company content in a centralized user experience. So it's a brand new modern intranet experience, as I named this. So what we are talking about today is Viva Connections. It's based on SharePoint, Yammer, Stream, and Teams. And the other modules are based on also all the Microsoft 365 services. So basically, just a few words about what is in preview and GA. So basically, right now, Viva Insights is in GA since September. Viva Topics is in GA since February, so global availability. It's available for everyone. Viva Learning is in preview, a public preview, since April, and the GA is will be available in November 2021. For Viva Connections, we had the first release of desktop experience in GA in March, and just in September, we got the updated desktop and the mobile experience available in public preview. The GA is planned for maybe the end of the year, so really quick. So all the modules will be in GA at the end of the year. So this is really cool. So as you might see on your tenant, you got some messages about public preview of Viva Connection, and this is actually rolling out for target tenant, and maybe for the production tenant it's going to be really quick, but I think the targeted tenants are up to date with the public preview right now. So just a few words about what is Viva Connection. So really quick, it's a gateway to a modern and centralized experience. So basically, you keep everyone engaged and informed through a dedicated experience. It's built on Microsoft 365 and mainly SharePoint. So basically, you have a fully integrated experience into Microsoft Teams. You can make audience targeting with Azure AD groups. You can aggregate news and conversation for SharePoint and Yammer, as Yammer include SharePoint news since the last release. You can integrate Yammer communities. You can integrate files and videos for OneDrive Mainstream. And at the end, we have the dashboard. Dashboard is in public preview. And this is where you can customize the experience with SharePoint framework. You have Power Apps and other third-party solutions. And I will show you what is the dashboard, what you can customize with SharePoint framework and all other things related to this feature. How to deploy Viva Connections? It's you have two ways. The old way about the mass release, it was a desktop experience only. Microsoft provided a PowerShell script to generate a Teams app package. And you deploy this app package through the Teams Admin Center through the setup policies. This experience is all available today. But right now, if you have a targeted tenant or maybe production, I don't know if the production is running out, but you can use the desktop and mobile experience directly from the Teams app catalog. It's disabled by default. You just enable the app and publish it to your user through setup policies. So basically, in the past, it was a desktop experience only. You need to generate an app package through a PowerShell script. And now you have a pre-built Teams app in your app catalog, and you are deploying this through the setup policies. So this is the fastest way right now. And what's new with Viva Connection? Because in the past, it was possible already to include some SharePoint pages, modern pages inside Teams for custom development. And now with Viva Connection, you have some better features, because in the past, the experience wasn't really good. It wasn't really optimized. So right now, with Viva Connection, you have a custom broadband app for your company in the mobile app and the desktop app. You have one-stop access to intranet resources. I will show you just after. It's a global navigation. You have the full integrated search for the search bar. You have a full screen mode with header and navigation, because in the past, when you include SharePoint modern pages inside Teams, it wasn't in the full screen mode. Sorry. You have new contextual actions, and basically you can include out of the box or custom experience based on SharePoint framework or other custom development. And the brand new dashboard and feed components, which are in public preview, but I will show you all this stuff just in a few slides. So basically, right now, what you get with Viva Connection desktop experience, you have a custom broadband app. You see on my screen, you have a dedicated app. You can customize the icon, the name, what you want. When you click on this app, you can access your intranet resources. It's what we call the global navigation on the side menu. We have in the search bar an integrated search for the whole intranet. I will show you just after. You have full screen mode with a header and navigation, and contextual action, which is really really nice feature, because I heard we can maybe customize this action in the future. So you have brand new contextual actions, and at the end we have the customer specific experience, like a custom made SharePoint framework web parts, or like this out of the box features. It's always available. And at the end, what is the dashboard and feed? This is what we call the dashboard report in the desktop experience. It's a brand new feature. It's a dashboard, and we have the feed. The feed is about user feed with a SharePoint news stream and other things related to the user. So basically, this was the desktop experience. So for extensibility option, the principle are really simple. You have the full control. You don't have a SharePoint site template for Viva Connection. It's what you want to include. It's open bar. You can include what you want. You can use out of the box and custom SharePoint framework web parts as normally in any SharePoint site. You can extend the experience with header and footer. I will show you an example of a footer extension I've made for this session. And one of the really important and really cool feature about SharePoint Framework right now, you can expose custom development made with SharePoint Framework in Viva Connection, SharePoint, and Teams. So you have three targets in one more in one only development. So you develop once for Viva Connection, SharePoint, and Teams. This is really quick and this is really nice. And at the end, you can customize the dashboard with adaptive card extensions. This is a new, brand new component in the SharePoint framework world to extend the dashboard. But for me, one of the really amazing features is the capability to expose one feature in Viva Connection, SharePoint, and Teams. So three targets and only one time development. So this is really nice. Just a quick recap of what you can do in Microsoft 365 with SharePoint Framework. So basically, every day you are extending, Microsoft is extending the capability. So basically, right now you can develop Teams personal app, you can extend the Teams meeting, you have a Viva Connection card, you can create a SharePoint full page and other things like this. So basically, this is a quick recap of what you can do in Microsoft 365 with the SharePoint framework. And I heard in the next year, there will be a lot of new experiences available. So be ready for this. I heard it's going to be really nice. So basically, I'm waiting for this too. So just a quick recap of the main components available. So the first is WebPart. Basically, it runs in the context of a sign-in user. You have no iframes. It's framework agnostic, but basically, by default, you are using React. But if you want to use Angular, Vue.js, Knockout, Handlebars, you can. It's open for you. But basically, when you are using React, all the basic library like Fluent UI and other things like this are available by default. If you are using Vue.js, Angular, or other stuff like this, you need to build yourself everything. You can use the web part in classic and modern pages. It's available on premises. It's possible to extend SharePoint 2016, and SharePoint Framework Web Part can be used to extend Microsoft Teams, like I said before, personal app, team tab, app, meeting app, and other extension points available in the coming year and maybe months. So basically, if you want to access some of the main features in Microsoft 365, like Microsoft Graph, you have Microsoft Graph Client Class. It's a full access to the API. With all scopes, you have API permission to declare in the manifest file. Be careful of this because you need to approve the API permission in the SharePoint Admin Center. A great feature inside the community is Microsoft Graph Toolkit. It's pre-built UI component to access basic feature in the Microsoft Graph, like agenda, calendar, Teams channel picker, or like this. The new version 2.3.0 is available. And you have brand new components, file and file list, and you can use it right now in SPFX SharePoint framework. If you want to use the REST SharePoint REST API, you have the SP HTTP client. And if you want to use Azure AD protected API, you have the AD HTTP client class where you can call or make make REST call on Azure Function, API management, .Nectar Web API, or like this. It's really amazing. You have free different classes for everything you need to query inside Microsoft SharePoint Framework. Microsoft Graph Toolkit, really amazing community project, MGT. So with MGT, you have pre-built components like person, people, people card. You integrate in your SharePoint Framework project and it's done. It's really quick. You just import the library and you have all pre-built components to use inside your development stuff. So I will show you some web part I made with Microsoft Graph Toolkit and it's really quick. So if you need to be really fast in your SPFx development, use the Microsoft Graph Toolkit because you don't need to redevelop the same basic feature like People Picker, Team Channel Picker. It's available with Microsoft Graph Toolkit. So don't remade the work the community made for you. Application Customizer is another important piece in the SharePoint framework. With Application Customizer, you can customize header and footer in a site. So basically, in Viva Connection, when you are creating your site for Viva Connection, you can customize the header and footer. I made some customization like this in the demo, just a quick customization. But I saw in a few days ago some guys who made really great header and footer for Viva with a custom custom menu, custom cascading styles, and like this, it was really quick. Sorry, really nice. And right now, with Application Customizer, you have only header and footer, but more locations are coming soon. This is considered by Microsoft for user voice. Basically, user voice will be shut down, but Microsoft will follow this. I heard next year we will have some more location in Application Customizer in the context of Viva Connection. Maybe contextual actions, as I said before, or like this. I don't know very well, but I think it's coming. Just a quick about Field Customizer. It's like a JSON formatting, but you can add custom logic with TypeScript code. So if you don't need complex logic, use JSON formatting. When you want to use TypeScript, use Field Customizer in SharePoint framework. List view command set, you can customize the actions inside your list. Basically, if you don't need custom actions or complex logic, just use out of the box. But if you need complex logic, use list view command set with TypeScript code. Yeah, you can query graph or like this. It's possible. And at the end, we have the library component. It's just a shared code through the SharePoint app catalog. So when you have, for example, multiple features that are sharing the same core features, you use library. So basically, when you are maybe, for example, you are querying Microsoft Graph, sometimes I'm making a library with all my call, and I'm creating generic calls, for example, to get a user, to get some properties inside Microsoft Graph, like a custom extension or like this. I'm creating a library, and I'm using this library in my whole project components. So this is a really nice feature. Library, it's important. At the end, we have just a little bit about Power Apps and Power BI, but it's not really the main topic for Viva Connection because right now, Power Apps, you have a native web part. It's integrated with Power Apps or Dataverse for Teams, but the main problem at the moment is the license. To access the apps inside SharePoint, you need to have a premium license, and you need to share the app to the whole company, but the main problem is the license. So basically, you need to have a premium license to access the app. So basically, it's not really useful because if you need a premium license for the whole company, it's not really good. And the Power BI is like the Power Apps. You need a pro or premium license to integrate some report inside SharePoint. So basically, and actually, the Power Platform is not a main part for Viva Connection customization. The main topic for Viva Connection customization and its extension is the SharePoint framework. I heard Microsoft is working on Power Apps to make some dashboard customization or like this, but it's not on the way soon. Maybe we'll see in the coming weeks. Right now, you are waiting for this. I think I'm going to the public preview features. So this is the dashboard feed and like this. So basically, the mobile experience, it's a brand new. Basically, the mobile experience is integrated in the Teams mobile app. So basically, you can customize the app directly in the Teams app catalog. So you are customizing the icons, the names, the description, and all the information about the app. You are deploying the app for Teams Admin Center setup policies. And inside the mobile experience, you can have, sorry, adaptive cards and SharePoint and Teams app if you want to develop customization like this. The brand new features is the adaptive card extension. So basically, you can build custom cards for the dashboard through adaptive card extension. This is the first of many upcoming extension points to be released by Microsoft. So maybe in the future we have more SharePoint framework components to extend Viva Connection, like maybe the feed web part or like this. It's available with SharePoint framework 1.13. It's currently in release candidate, so the GI will be available really soon. You have card templates available, like basic card, image card, primary text. I will show you the free templates just after. And right now, all these features related to SharePoint framework are in public preview. So you just need to install the SharePoint generator, the next tag. Don't forget to add the next tag and global tag. And you can use the SharePoint Online Workbench or directly the dashboard to test your card, deploy, and make your test. So it's available in public preview for everyone, so you can test. So this is just a quick screenshot about what is the new SharePoint generator. So you see you have a new component type called Adaptive Card Extension. It's currently in beta with SharePoint framework 1.13. And I will show you just after the structure of a new project for Adaptive Card Extension. It's really new. You have some brand new features, brand new components. So I will show you this just after. It's Adaptive Card Extension, the name of the new component in SharePoint framework. The mobile experience, you have three sections. The dashboard, it's a dashboard experience with configurable adaptive cards. Basically, I call this a quick access to different application and tools in your company. So maybe you can showcase some of the hidden tool in your company inside the dashboard. This is really nice. You have only one dashboard configurable for everyone in the company. So you can't create multiple dashboards. So if you want to create multiple dashboards for multiple people, you can enable audience targeting on the card. So you are building one dashboard and you are creating multiple cards with audience targeting to target the right people, like a finance team, like HR team with Azure AD security groups. So it's the same as audience targeting in SharePoint with news or pages or like this. The feed is just an aggregation of SharePoint News, Yammer, and Stream. And you have a new feature called Video News Link, where you can post in the feed a news link related to a video. So basically, only OneDrive and SharePoint stored video are available for Video News Link. And at the end, we have the resources sections. It's the global navigation of SharePoint and to access the intranet resources. And you can set up with your home site navigation or hub and global navigations. So basically, this is what is the mobile experience. Sorry, it's in French because my iPhone is in French. I didn't switch it in English mode. But you see, you have the dashboard, the first screenshot. You have the feed and the resources global navigation. So basically, it's a brand new experience inside Microsoft Teams mobile app. And I will show you just after how to customize the dashboard. This is the first screen. And this is what the adaptive cards are looking like. So basically, you can create an adaptive card out of the box with some features I will show you, or you can develop your own adaptive card with SharePoint framework and adaptive card extension. So this is what is the user interface of adaptive cards. So it's really integrated inside Microsoft Teams. The user interface is still in public preview, so be careful. Maybe there will be some changes in the displaying and other things like this. So we will see in the GA the final user experience, but this is what it looks like actually. And at the end, we have the SharePoint experience for dashboard. So basically, it's not only in the mobile experience. You can add a web part only on your home site. So the dashboard web part is only available on your home site. I will show you just after how to set up your home site. Basically, this is the adapted version of mobile experience inside SharePoint. So be careful because it's a mobile-first experience. So basically, you have the mobile experience in SharePoint. So you don't have any changes. It's just the mobile experience in SharePoint. Basically, this is what we call the dashboard web part. Extensibility model for the dashboard. Basically, if you want to develop your own card with adaptive card extension, you have three components. The card, it's required every time. You have second, the quick view. This is to show more information or advanced information. And at the end, this is the optional component. It's a custom experience you already created. Like if you have, for example, an expense approval system in place, you can create a card to send maybe notification or the user need to submit approval for the expense or like this. So basically, you have three components to the extensibility model. This is just a quick overview of the four steps when you are using an adaptive card. So basically, you are starting in the dashboard, you have the quick view, and after you can go inside Teams, inside the specific app, you have deep linking feature, or directly inside the browser. So basically, you have four steps you can achieve with adaptive cards. At the end, we have the feed experience, which is basically the same as a mobile experience. So it's just an aggregation, as I said, of SharePoint News, Yammer, and Stream. It's available as native web part in any site, not only on the home site. So any site can have the feed, as the dashboard is only available on the home site. Be careful. Basically, it's really simple because you don't have any customization, configuration possible. You can customize the settings of the feed. You can post videos, news link inside the feed with the new feature. It's only from SharePoint Online and OneDrive. You can't add YouTube video, Vimeo video, or like this. It's not available right now. And be careful, it's a mobile experience. So basically, it's just a mobile experience adapted inside SharePoint. So it's not really amazing. There is no changes from the mobile experience. And this is what we call the feed. You have, for example, you see the boosted news. You can have in the second card, it's a video news link, and you have the SharePoint News and Yammer stream. So basically, just a few conclusions at the end of this slide, and just after we are going through the demos. Viva Connection is the entry point of your modern intranet, because right now a lot of customers of mine are creating a modern intranet inside Teams with upsites, with Teams integrated sites, team sites, communication sites, and we are creating a hub and like this. So the modern intranet is based on Viva Connections. It's a mobile-first experience. So basically, Viva Connection is based on your mobile, and you have an experience in SharePoint if you want to use the web part. Actually, the extension points are actually pretty limited. So you, in the past, since March, the first version of the desktop experience, it wasn't really, really amazing. But right now, with the adaptive card extension, it's a really quick add. But for me, I'm waiting for more because right now it's pretty limited. So I'm waiting for the other extension point that Microsoft will release next year. Right now, it's really, for me, limited, but we can do some great things. So basically, just a quick reminder before the demo, you have prizes, and if you answer right the question, you will get some amazing prizes. And right now, this is the demo. So I've aggregate all you can find about Viva Connection extension points. So I have made some SharePoint framework with the latest GA. I've made some dashboard customization with the public preview. I made adaptive card, adaptive extension. I use React, Microsoft Graph Toolkit, and other things to build a portal with all the customization that you can do. So I put all the customization you can do at the moment. So let's go to the demo. I'm switching to my screen, and if you can see my screen, it's... Can you see my screen? It's okay? Oh, I think it's okay. So, perfect. If you want to deploy, first, just a quick reminder, if you want to deploy the Viva Connection app inside your tenant, I'm in the Teams Admin Center, and basically, if you go to Manage Apps, you can see I've renamed the app right now. It's Intranet, the new name of my app. But basically, you see, in your tenant, you will be this name. So when you are searching the app, you need to search for Viva Connection Preview. And you need to allow the app and deploy it through Setup Policy. So this is an app, a customizable app, you see. You can customize what you want. So you see, you can rename the app, the short description, and like this. So basically, you can do what you want with the app. Right now, I'm inside Microsoft Teams. You see, it's a brand new Viva Connection portal I've made with all the demos. So basically, just a quick overview. You see, I have the custom app for Viva Connections. I click on this app. You see, it's a global navigation. This is what we call SharePoint global navigation with the news, all my sites, and the menu. I've set it up this menu to be this menu, the home site menu, for simple reason. And inside the search, when I search something, you see you have a brand new menu, search in the intranet, so you can search directly in the search bar in Viva Connection intranet. You have the full screen navigation, because in the past the header and footer wasn't available, it was just the content of the page. You see you have the language picker and the contextual action, which are not available in the SharePoint mode. I mean, Teams context, and in SharePoint context, you don't have these contextual actions. And now, for example, first, I've made, you see, my agenda, my personal links. This is custom report made with Microsoft Graph Toolkit. So basically, you can extend the experience with custom report, like my agenda, where you see all the meetings. I have personal links report. I have my recent documents. It's based on the insights from Microsoft 365 and Microsoft Graph Toolkit. You can upload files with Microsoft Graph Toolkit too. Inside, you see, you have the dashboard. I will come back just after. This is a dashboard view. You can check the cards. You have the feed. The feed is just a news feed with all the aggregated content from Microsoft 365 services. At the end, on the top, you have SharePoint, Yammer communities. It's out of the box. And as I said, you have Pro BI report. I have a license Pro, so I can access. And you have a Power Apps. So basically, if you have license, you can access. If you don't have premium license or Power BI Pro, you don't see, you have an error message. So basically, it's not really relevant for Viva Connection at the moment about Power Apps and Power BI. If you see at the bottom of the page, this is not the out-of-the-box footer. I've developed a custom footer with SharePoint Framework. I made the same team and design as the site, but it's not the out-of-the-box footer. So basically, with SharePoint Framework, you can customize the header and footer. I've customized only the footer, and I've made just a quick title and some links. But if you want, you can extend the whole experience. So you can make new design. You can use like Framework to make some UI UI different from SharePoint. You can create amazing header and footer if you want to customize the whole experience. Because some customer doesn't want or don't want the SharePoint-like design, so they want to hide the SharePoint theme or colors or like this, and we need to be careful. But it's really advanced feature, but you can customize header and footer. So basically, you see, I'm in Teams right now. And when I switch on SharePoint, you see, you don't have the contextual action. This is the site I've made, but in the SharePoint context. This is the same experience, but you have some differences, like the contextual action, you see. In Teams, it's different. So at the moment, you don't see so many differences between Teams and SharePoint, but in the future, maybe you will have different experiences. So basically, the dashboard. For the dashboard, basically, when you want to set up a dashboard, you need to go to the settings, and you see you have a brand new menu, Setup Viva Connections. And you see, if you don't have a dashboard, you can create one. You have a button and create dashboard. My dashboard is already created, so I click on View Dashboard. And you see, it's a configuration page. So basically, if you edit the dashboard, you have an overview of what it looks like in the mobile experience and in the desktop. You see, mobile and desktop. Basically, if you want to add a card, you can add a card with this button. And by default, you have a card designer, You have a Teams app, web link, and assigned task. This with SharePoint icons are my custom adaptive card extension. So I will show you what this looks like just after. But for example, if I want to create a web link, I can create a web link and customize the card. It's out of the box. So you just provide a link and like this. This is out of the box features. And you can do the same with, for example, Teams app. So in this case, you can search, you see, you can search for a Teams app. Only the Teams app available and compatible with Viva Connection are showing in this list. So basically, Viva Learning is compatible. Some other of my applications are compatible and ready for Viva Connections. So only the Teams app ready for Viva Connection are showing in this list. Basically, the end is when you want to use, for example, assigned task is just the planner task, and there will be a shift web part available when Viva Connection will be in GA in the coming weeks. And the end is the card designer. For example, when you want to develop a custom card extension with SharePoint framework, sometimes you have maybe graphical designer or communication specialist, and they can create their own mock-up. So basically, if you want to use an example site, adaptivecards.io, you can build with a simple user interface your own card. So basically, when you want to use maybe this template, you can generate the template. Your graphical designer or communication specialist can create a mock-up of what they want to show in the user, and after they can just, paste the code, JSON code here, and you can see what it looks like. For example, this card, you see, I made just a quick adaptive card with all the codes generated from the site. So basically, this is a mock-up. You don't have any interaction or dynamic call or like this. This is a static card. And when I go back to my dashboard, so basically, I have some custom cards here. So basically, this is the first, it's Graph Directory. Basically, it's a Graph Directory based on Microsoft Graph. So I'm just showing the user, you have 19 users inside your tenant, and you can, you see, you have the quick view, and you can see all the users in the tenant. The second is my group. So you see, you belong to 35 groups. So it's showing how many groups the user belong to, and you can have a quick view of what are the groups, and you can click on the group to have the details. So I have two quick views for this adaptive card extension. You can go back. Teams message is just to send message for Teams to specific people. So I can put the message, for example, test, and I can send the message to the user. So you see, I have a quick view to show the success or the failed of the send message. This is the Microsoft demo of the public preview. On the Microsoft Docs, you have this web part. You see, it's just a list view switcher. So when I edit this web part, you see, it's linked to a list. You have a list ID, and you can navigate to the items. I have three items, so you can go to the three items with this buttons. Basically, you see, you have two types of cards. You have large cards, which is the size of two cards, and the medium card is one card. Basically, two sizes for this dashboard. And when I'm on the home page, for example, I edit the home page, you see, in the dashboard experience could be a little bit customized, because in the web part, I can't show a specific number of cards. So basically, in this case, I'm showing only 9 cards, but you can show 11 cards at maximum. So basically, I'm still at 9. This is what we called the dashboard web part. And basically, the mobile experience will be the same inside Microsoft Teams, but in a different context. You will have a different layout, but the cards are the same. The layout will be different because you are in mobile in Teams, but the layout will be the same across the platforms. The feed is really not finished, I guess, because you don't have so many settings. So basically, sorry, just go back to this. You see, you don't have, sorry, you don't have any settings at the moment for the feed. So basically, I guess there will be maybe some extension from SharePoint framework to extend maybe to create content types or like this or like a news feed. But right now, it's really not advanced configuration. It's really basic stuff. And as I said, you can use video news links. So you can post, for example, I've made in this card, it's a video link news. So basically, when you click, you are going to the video. You see, it's redirected to the video. And you can go back to the site. Sorry. And we are go. So basically, when you are in admin mode, or sorry, it's not here. It's here. You can create a new video news link here. So you post the link of the video, like OneDrive or SharePoint link, and you are done. You can post on the feed. Basically, for those who want to see what a SharePoint framework project look like in Adaptive Card Extension, so basically, I've provisioned a brand new basic card template. So basically, the structure is the same of a SharePoint framework classic project, but you see in the SRC file, the folder, sorry, you have brand new folder. So basically, you have one for the assets, it's the logo, picture, or like this. You have the card view, which is the main view of your card. It's required for every project. You have the quick view to develop your quick view. You see, you have a template file, and the template file contains, you see, it's the adaptive card JSON code. So basically, this is a simple JSON code, and with SharePoint framework, you integrate, you see, you can inject your data inside the card. With SharePoint framework, it's really quick. So basically, you can create multiple quick views with multiple templates. You don't need to use an external file like JSON file. You can use directly in your code to generate your JSON. It's not required to create a JSON file inside the template folder, because you can generate with a TypeScript code your JSON directly inside your method. So basically, you have the manifest, and you see the manifest in the supported host, you have dashboard. What I mean, this is what we call the dashboard feature. So we are declaring the dashboard inside the supported host to be available in Viva connections. So basically, this is what we change. Basically, you see it's a TypeScript, and basically it's the same structure as a basic SharePoint framework code with the onInit feature method. Sorry, you have brand new method for example, to render the card, to get the property pan, because every card has a property pan. You see, you can customize the property pan here, and basically, you see, you can customize your quick view inside this file. Basically, you see, I'm using an external template called quick view template just JSON, or what you want to call. But inside this method, if you want to generate your template directly inside this method with TypeScript, it's possible. And the card view. So this is basically the basic view of your card. So you see, you have primary text for the primary text of your card. You can open an external link on when you click on the card. So basically, you have some new feature. I'm not going through deeper inside the SharePoint framework, because I will make another session in other conferences based on how to start developing your own card for SharePoint framework and adaptive card extension. So basically, I'm just showing you the base project structure, but I'm not going deeper in this topic. And at the end, I have just forgot to show you just one feature, which is important. So for the card, basically, when you edit one card, you see, you can make audience targeting. So basically, you are limited to one dashboard for the whole tenant. Basically, if you want to make multiple experiences for multiple people, like HR, finance, or like this, you can use the audience targeting feature to provide multiple experiences, but you create only one dashboard. It's limited to one at the moment. So basically, I'm done. because I was planned to have a 45-minute session and maybe 10 minutes for technical question. Maybe we can go back to other feature if you want to get more information. I can show you specific topics in my presentation, but I'm done, and I've give you all the features which are available to extend Viva Connection right now. So basically, if you have any question right now, feel free to ask. We have 15 minutes left.
Yeah, we have 15 minutes left. Is there any question from the floor? Or you have anything else to share, Avis? Okay, there is no question, is it? All right, thank you for your session. It was very great session. And you are the last one for developer track for today. We're going to have another day for tomorrow. Participants do join us again for tomorrow. Tomorrow we start at 9 a.m. 9 a.m. in the morning, plus 8 GMT until 4. Okay, for today we're going to wrap at 5 our local time. For tomorrow we're going to wrap at 4. Okay, anything else you want to say, Vis?
No, I'm done. If you have any question, you can contact me on the Twitter or my website. I'm answering every question, so feel free to contact me if you have after the session. If you have just a question, feel free to ask on my website or social network feed.
Okay, maybe you can drop your social network feed in the chat box so they can contact you.
Yeah, you can contact me. Yeah. I've dropped my website and my Twitter, so feel free to ask me. I'm answering everything, but sometimes with a little bit delay, but I'm answering everything. So if you have a technical
Okay.
question, implementation question, or technical stuff, you can ask.